Wednesday, I spoke about what we need to do as a country to build a better bargain for the middle class, to make sure everyone who works hard has a chance to get ahead in the 21st century economy. You see, this week I went down to an Amazon warehouse in Tennessee to talk more about what we need to do to secure a better bargain for the middle class, to make sure that anyone who works hard can get ahead in the 21st century economy. Over the past few weeks, I've been visiting folks across America to talk about what we need to do as a country to secure a better bargain for the middle class. Over the past few weeks, I've been visiting with Americans across the country to talk about what we need to do to secure a better bargain for the middle class. Over the past month, I've been visiting towns across America, talking about what our country needs to do to secure a better bargain for the middle class. But there's also a faction on the far right of a better bargain for the middle class. Good jobs, a good education, a chance to buy.
By pooling the uninsured and small businesses together as one big group, we give insurance companies an incentive to participate and give consumers leverage to bargain for better prices and quality coverage.
And by the way, what we shouldn't do, I just got to say this, what we shouldn't be doing is trying to take away your rights to bargain for better wages or working conditions. Creating more good jobs, a better bargain for the middle class, helping folks who are working to join the middle class, an economy that grows from the middle out. This isn't what I'm going to be focusing on for the next few months. This is what I'm going to be focusing on for all the days I've got left in my presidency. I've counted. Over the past few weeks, I've been talking about what I believe should be our number one priority as a country, building a better bargain for the middle class and for Americans who want to work their way into the middle class.
And Joe and I are going to keep pushing for a better bargain for the middle class, a better bargain for the next generation. And
my position is, if folks in this town want a grand bargain, how about a grand bargain for middle-class jobs? So I put forward ideas for tax reform. Haven't heard back from them yet.
Now, a couple months ago, I put forward an idea to try to break through some of the old arguments. A grand bargain for middle-class jobs. And
we would have a grand bargain for middle-class jobs that combines tax reform with a financing mechanism that lets us create jobs, rebuilding infrastructure that your businesses depend on. But we haven't gotten as much take-up from the other side as we'd like to see so far.
One of the reasons that wages have not grown faster over the last couple of decades is because some politicians, some businesses, some laws have undermined the ability of workers to bargain for a better deal. And that needs to change.
Vietnam, that for the first time is debating in a very serious way how they can provide protections to their workers and allow them to participate and have voice and bargain for wages. And yeah, that's tough politically for Vietnam. And that means that workers and unions oftentimes have less leverage to bargain for better wages, better benefits, have more difficulty competing in the global marketplace.